of the one-child policy in China. China's one-child for couple policy is expressive effect on fertility rates was established in 1979 by Yuan Bingzhang. I want to ask you, do you know about this policy? Today, I want to talk about the one-child policy. I think the one-child policy is not good for China's future. I think some of you have seen Chinese have more than one children here. And then, but in China, the one-child policy forces people to only have one child. And then if the government find out the family have more than one child, and the parents will lose their job. I'm not Chinese, and because of the one-child policy, I'm the only child in my family. In China, almost everyone in my age are the only child in their family. After I have done the research, I think the one-child policy is not good for China's future. First, I will talk about some problems in the one-child policy. And then second, I will talk about what one-child policy costs. And then third, I will talk about how to solve these problems. And first, I want to show you a video about the one-child policy.
From roughly 700 million residents in the 1960s to more than a billion in the 1980s, Chinese officials implemented the one-child policy. In 2011, the government claimed that the policy and other birth control methods have led to the prevention of 400 million births. However, critics point out that the drop in births is due to lower fertility rates, which are consistent with lower rates in countries without such policies like Thailand.
Traditionally, a responsibility of children, especially in countryside, around 60% of the new workforce is untitled in transition. It's also from the article, the one-child policy, the good, bad, and the article. Second, I will talk about the cost by the one-child policy. In some of the farmer families, when they find out that they carry a girl and they will make an abortion because they can only have one child in their family and girl does not have a strong labor for the family. Second is the repeat decrease in the birth rate combined with single or improved life expansion. Was leading to an increase proportion of elderly people and increase in the ratio between elderly people and adult children. In China, the percentage of population over the age of 65 years was 5% in 1982 and now stands at 7.5%, but is expected to increase to more than 15% by 2025, by the effect of China's one-child family policy after 25 years. And then this graph is about the family dependency ratio. And then now you can see from the one-child policy is began from the 1979. And then the child dependency ratio is increased, and then the old age dependency ratio is increased. So it means that at the 2050, the China will have more older people than the young people. The solution for the one child policy is to lead the family to have more than one child, and then the government can react on the one child policy. And for now, the China's government have a new policy. It's called the two children policy. It means that one family can have two children in their family. And then it started from the 2015. In conclusion, I think the one child policy is not good for China's future because they have more older people than young people in the population. So in my speech, I first talk about what are the problems in the one child policy, and then second, I talk about what one child policy costs. And then third, I talk about how to solve these problems. I hope you can have a better sense of what is one-child policy in China and why I think the policy is not good for China's future.